shaking hands at center court now. The House and Sage jumping. Kids go all around, taking everybody's hands here, kind of matching up a little bit. See who comes up with the tap here. The Panthers, they set up only one person back. Tap is up, and it's going to be controlled by the Glacier Bears. Swinton comes up with it. He'll bring it across the half-court line. Wants to go right with the dribble now to Cox. Looks like it's going to be a man-to-man defense by the Panthers right now, just beginning first quarter play here. Goes left-hand side, just on the wing. Come back out to Stugan. He goes right inside to Cox, looking for a cutter down the lane. Goes Swinton, stops, slips. Ball back out, it's on the floor. Who's going to come up with it? Looks like Cox will come away with it. He goes back inside to Sage, up and in. So Hudson Sage comes away with it. Here's the first 2 points of Glacier Bears. They pick him up at half court. Quickly across the court is House. He goes right hand side, can't find anybody, and they're going to reverse it all the way back around. And taking off on the travel was Marker. He saw that lane and he wanted it, but forgot to dribble. Looks like just a bit of pressure going to be applied by the Panthers right now. Burnham puts some pressure on Cox, but he'll get it up across the half-court line on the left-hand dribble. Reverses back, goes right-hand side to Stegan. Stegan holds the ball high over his head, throws it too low, goes through the feet of Swinton, but he's able to gain control. Now he'll bring it back out to the top and set it up. 7 minutes to go here in the first quarter. Glacier Bears lead 2-0, first score of the ball game. Green, pick and roll, doesn't get it, however, back to Swinton on the left baseline, stops, kicks the ball back inside to Green, goes up, puts up the shot, going to be checked, and saving it nicely with Swinton over in that left-hand corner. Now he tries to go inside to Sage, knocked away, however, by the Panthers, and they're quick up the court. Comes Vickers, stops, puts up the shot, going to be a travel on Vickers as he slipped, came down to try to set it up, only 3 or 4 feet from the basket, though. His feet slipped from out from under him, and of course the travel was called. Comes back to Cox, he'll bring it across the half-court line. 6:32 to go here. First quarter action. Cox goes all the way back out to Sage. Going to be a whistle on the fast over to Sage, who is on the right baseline. Grounded. Going to be on 2-4. That'll be Zach Vickers. That'll be his first personal foul, first team foul on the Panthers. Glacier Bears have the ball underneath. Green holds it. Looking. Finally goes to Cox. Nice defense by the Panthers that time as Cox wanted a jumper, but quickly over there is Vickers and shut that off. Now Cox goes right-hand side to Stegan. Looks inside. Kill can't find it. Reverses it back out to Green, who just about loses it. Over the game control. Glacier Bears cutting across the lanes, looking for that open hole. They go down to Sage. Puts it up too hard off the glass. Rebound down to Marker, and he's quick on the dribble down the right-hand side. He wants to go to the baseline, does. Kicks it back out. Going to be knocked out of bounds by one of the Glacier Bears. I'm not sure if it's Swinton or Sage. Anyhow, the ball's going to go to the Craig Panthers under their basket on the left-hand side. Glacier Bears 2-3 zone right now. Looking. They kick the ball back out to House, who comes back inside, and they'll bring it back out to Jacobson. Go over the top. Nice little Marker. They'll reverse the ball back around to Burnham. They'll just play on the outside. Glacier Bears long three-pointer on the way off the front of the iron. Swinton down with the rebound. Glacier Bears are playing a 2-3 zone. They go cross court. Stepped in the passing lane nicely that time. Was House, and he's on the dribble. Goes all the way to the hoop. Going to be out of bounds. Off of one of the Panthers. Glacier Bears are going to get it. Well, one thing I noticed right off here is the Panthers get that ball down the court right away. They push it down. Cox over on the left-hand side. Now there's going to be a whistle. See where the foul is going to be here.
Illegal screen on Green.
I think it's illegal screen on Green. It was pretty obvious, but I didn't want to say it until the official made that statement because we could see it from here. Now we're all the way down. Green makes a steal, though, on the long pass. Goes to Cox. Left-handed dribble goes down the lane. Now there's going to be a whistle. Coming back from behind was Burnham. That'll be second team foul on the Panthers. Glacier Bears will have it. 5:20 to go here in the first quarter. Still 2-0. Glacier Bears with the lead and the basketball. Looking, they finally get it out to Stegan, left-hand side. He comes back inside. Knocked away nicely by Jacobson. He goes all the way up. Nobody there. Lays it up and in. That's the first 2 points for the Panthers. 2-2 is the score. Cox will bring it down. Long down court pass to Stegan. He looks inside, can't find anybody. Man-to-man defense by the Panthers. Cox goes down hard to the hoop, draws the foul, and looks like he's going to get the basket. We'll see if the official is going to count it. Foul is on 24. That'll be his second and count the basket. So Trevor Cox is going to pick up his first 2 points of the basketball game, and he'll be going to the free throw line for the first free throws of the ball game. 5:02 to go here in the first quarter of play. Glacier Bears 4, Panthers 2. Shots on his way, looks good, and is. So he gets the first one to go. Little pressure being applied by the Glacier Bears. Three-quarter court. They break it easily, however, as they go to Burnham. He comes back down. Almanzor checked in. Long three-pointer on the way in and out. No, it doesn't go. Rebound fought for. Swinton comes away with it. Now there's going to be a foul on it. 3-0. Gabe Almanzor is going to pick up his first personal foul. Didn't really need to reach in. Swinton had the ball in his control, and Gabe just thought he could get it away and didn't happen, however. So he picks up the fourth team foul on the Panthers right away. They go right-hand side. Nothing going, however, is checking into the ball game was Cunningham, though. Goes back into Green, puts up the little jumper, and he's got it. So Matthew Green puts up his first 2 points. Pressure again being applied by the Glacier Bears. Long down that pass to Marker. He goes up to the hoop and lays it up. And in. He went hard to the hoop and got the bucket out of it. 7-4 is the score. Glacier Bears with a 3-point lead, but they have the ball. Cox, left-hand side, goes to Swinton. Looks inside for Sage. Looking, still can't go anything. Comes back out to Cunningham. Takes a couple of dribbles. And there's going to be a timeout on it here. We'll see what it's going to be here. We're not quite sure yet. They haven't given us a signal on this side. It's going to be a 30-second timeout. So, I mean, it's much like we thought probably was going to happen. A little bit of pressure by both teams and go under the hoop hard of the Panthers.
Yeah, when they get the ball on the wing, like with that last one with Marker, yeah, he took that hard, went right in there, and was able to convert it. Not a lot of outside shooting from either one. The Glacier Bears trying to post up Sage, but he needs to do a little better job making a bigger target. But I've seen him do it in the past. I think it's probably just some early first game jitters in there, because if they get Hudson going down on that baseline, it's going to be tough to stop him.
Well, between Hudson and Swinton both, they need either one of them to get down on that line. But the Panthers are pretty good about filling those passing lanes also. Glacier Bears are going to have to work for that shot. Full court man-to-man pressure by the Panthers right now. Green one inbound right here in front of the Craig bench. They go back to Cox on the dribble. 4 minutes to go here in the first quarter of play. Cox calls out the play. Glacier Bears set it up. Now there's some movement. They come out to the side. Go right-hand side to Cunningham. He looks inside. Takes a couple dribbles down the lane. Kicks it back out to Cox. Jumper on the way from the baseline. No rebound down to Green. He goes back up. Puts up the shot up. And in. But Matthew Green got a nice rebound out and went hard to the hoop. Coming quickly down the court. Now there's going to be a foul again here on it. Cunningham's going to pick up that foul for the Glacier Bears. A little bit too much pressure on as the Panthers were pushing the ball hard down the court. Second team foul on the Glacier Bears. Back out to the top. Marker will take it. Glacier Bears 2-3 zone defense. Hands up. And not cutting anything back. And long three-pointer on the way. And there's going to be a foul. And that three-point shot by Marker come charging out was Cox, a little bit out of control. So Trevor Cox is going to pick up his first personal foul, and that's going to send Marker to the free throw line. Third team foul. He's going to get three free throws out of this. First one is good. He gets it to go. That's his third point. Cuts into that lead a little bit. 9-5. Glacier Bears 4-point lead. Second one's on the way. This one rolls around and finally drops. He got every bit of the iron on that before it finally fell through. And he picks up his fourth point. Down to a 3-point lead now for the Glacier Bears. Third one's on its way. This one is nothing but net. They got a lane violation, however, on number 20, so that one's not going to count. He did get in there a bit early, though. All right, full court pressure by the Panthers. Cox over to Indiana. Or Green, excuse me. Green looked back, and Cox wasn't looking. Green tried to hang on to the ball, came down. And, of course, there's going to be a call for the travel on it, so it's going to be Panther basketball under their basket. Jacobson has it. He goes right-hand side to Almanzor. He wants the baseline. He's got it. Kicks the ball back out. Up and in. Nice pass that time as he went inside to Zach Jacobson. He had a little bunny, laid it up and in. 1-point lead. And coming down the court now are the Glacier Bears. Kick the ball back inside, knocked out of bounds as they try to go into Sage. House comes across, gets a hand on it, knocks it out of bounds. A lot of pressure being applied by the Panthers right now. Glacier Bears just need to calm down a bit. Green with the basketball, left-hand side, looking for Sage. Ooh, he passed it down too low. Sage was all alone. Nothing happened there. Now they throw the ball back in, and it looks like Sage is going to get called on the foul as he reached back to try to knock the ball away. That was a great play by the Glacier Bears. I mean, they had an easy bucket out of it, just a kind of a poor pass. Hudson was expecting it up around his chest, but he got the ball down around his knees. Full court pressure by the Glacier Bears. 2-2-1 zone press. They come right-hand side. Coming down the court quickly is Marker. He kicks the ball off over the house. Puts up the shot. No rebound. Back comes back into Almanzor's hands, and he puts it up and in. And now the lead goes to the Craig Panthers, 10-9. 2:57 to go here in the first quarter. We go to Cunningham. He goes across to Swenton. Puts it up too low off the back of the glass. Rebound comes back down to hands of Swenton. Knocked out of bounds off his hands. Back to Stegen. He tries to go back inside. Stolen away nicely, however, by Burnham. He goes all the way down to House. Puts it up and in. So House went hard to the hoop and got that lay-in. Like we said, they go to the hoop hard. They lead by three now. Glacier Bears break the press. They get across to Swenton. Swenton goes hard to the hoop. Stops. Goes by. Going to be a whistle. Bowden Swenton went hard to the hoop here. Officials are talking it over. There is only one person standing there, but they wanted to make sure they got it. The foul is on number four, Zach Jacobson. That will be his first personal foul and the fifth team foul now on the Panthers. Glacier Bears at the free throw line. This is their second chance. It comes up a bit short on it, however. 12-9, 2:27 to go here in the first quarter of play. Up and off the front of the iron, no. Rebound comes back down the hands of the Panthers, and a lot of pressure being applied by Cunningham, but Burnham easily breaks it, however, or Marker does, stops, puts up the shot, no, off the glass, rebound to Almanzor. He goes up high, back to Marker again, this time it's on the way too hard off the glass, rebound down to Stegen. He gets it out to Swenton, over to Cox, 2 minutes to go. They kick the ball back down in that quarter, they try to go inside, House knocks it away back into Sage, puts it up and in. Sage was just camping right there, waiting for that pass. Got it. Put the left-handed lay-in up and in. He gives only a one-point lead to the Panthers. Fight for the ball underneath. Here comes up with it. Goes over Cox. He's on the dribble to the right-hand side. Going to be a whistle on it. I said it's before the basket. The basket did go in. Fouls on 2-0. Timber Burnham. That would be his second personal foul. And into a bit of foul trouble, two on Burnham, two on Vickers, and they're both coming out of the ball game. Checking into the ball game is records for the Panthers right now. 1:47 to go here in this first quarter of play. Craig 12, Haines 11. They go back inside to Cox, all alone up and in. Nice play that time as Cox came around the outside. Just a nice, easy little lay-in out of it. Defense wasn't set up for that one very well. They come quickly down to the left-hand side to House. He comes, reverses it back around. Now driving down the center of the lane, puts up the shot. No rebound, fought for underneath. Put it back up again. Records doesn't go. Rebound comes down to the Glacier Bears, and they immediately turn it over to Almanzor. Almanzor goes down to the hoop, and it's quickly turned over. Sage all alone down, and he lays in. Hudson Sage is in the right spot at the right time. 1:12 to go here in this first quarter of play. Almanzor on the dribble across. Going to be a foul on Cox. A little bit of I guess you might call a little bit of rat ball here as we're going in this last minute and a half here. Glacier Bears 15, Panthers 12. Now they're out at the top. Panthers with the ball at the top. They'll dribble it around, goes right inside. Good defense that time by the Glacier Bears. Long shot off the front of the iron. No rebound, fought for underneath. Rebound comes back down in the hands of the Glacier Bears, and they're quick up the court, but they almost lose it. Now they do. Almanzor comes up with it, and all alone going up and in. Missed the shot, however, for the Panthers. He gets his own board back, misses the second time, fights for it again underneath. House comes away with it. Glacier Bears need to secure that board. They come back out. Long three-pointer on the way. No. Records comes back down the hands of Records, and they reverse it back around. Another three-pointer on the way. This one off the back of the iron. No, Almanzor fought for it underneath. They'll kick it back out. That's about 7-8 rebounds now. The Glacier Bears have given up. Going to be down the lane. Nothing called on it. Goes out of bounds. He went hard to the lane. Was bumped a couple times. No fouls called, however. Coming back into the game will be Burnham with 16 seconds to go here. Looks like Marker will take a quick seat. Checking into the ballgame for the Glacier Bears. Jacobson checks in there. Full court pressure by the Panthers. The Glacier Bears turn the basketball over right at half court. So the Panthers will have a chance here with 12.5 seconds to go here in this first quarter of play. Panthers land down the basketball. Goes over to Burnham. Reverse it back around. They'll go back inside the house. He's completely surrounded. Try to go to Almanzor. He hasn't fought back underneath. Almanzor all alone up and in. Gabe Almanzor is a good. He's a 5'11" freshman, but he can get up there. But we're going to end this first period of play with the Haines Glacier Bears 15 and the Craig Panthers 14. We're going to turn it back to KRBB for 1 minute. We'll be back in 1 minute. Gymnasium here. Glacier Bears 15, Craig Panthers 14. Rebounding, Glacier Bears 6 in that quarter. Craig Panthers come up with 9. Ton of offensive rebounds down there.
And we won't even talk 6 or 7 of those all on that last sequence just before halftime.
Glacier Bears 7 for 10 at 70%. Panthers 6 for 19 at 32%.
Panthers ball at the start of the second quarter. We've got Burnham, Almanzor, Jacobson, House, and Records in there. Up top to Burnham. Burnham looked a little 2-3 zone against the Glacier Bears. Goes right-hand side to Records. Records on the baseline to Almanzor. Into a cutting house, partially blocked by Swift. Rebound comes down to Green. Green has it stolen from behind. Fight for it on the floor. And we're going to have a held ball on the court for the Glacier Bears. Catch Jacobson. Matthew Green. Dylan Swinton. Jacob Stegen and Trevor Cox. Cox against 2-3 or 2-2-1 zone half-court press here for the Panthers. Gets it to Swinton. Swinton drives the baseline, and he's going to be fouled going up for the shot. Let's see who they're going to call the foul on. Number one, Morgan House, his first personal. 17th foul. Swinton will be at the line shooting two. Swinton's first is up off the back rim, front rim, no good. Swinton back in the line. His second one is up. This one he gets to go through. His first point of the game. And that's a two-point lead for the Glacier Bears. Quickly back the other way of the Panthers. Go down on the right-hand side to Burnham for a long shot. Rebounds coming down to Green, coming over the top of him. Is going to be, I think it's going to be number three, Isaiah Records, his first personal, 18th foul. Crashing hard for that rebound. And that's going to be a bonus situation because that was seventh. That's 18 fouls now, so we're in a one-on-one situation. So I think it'll be Matthew Green that should be going to the line for the Glacier Bears. And shooting, that was a pretty easy one to call. Matthew had the rebound, and Records came in from the three-point line, jumped on his back. I've done that a time or two. So Green at the line for, he's got 4 from the field so far. This is his first chance from the free throw line. That is up, off the backboard, no good. Rebound comes down to Almanzor. Almanzor quickly up into the front court, goes right hand side to Burnham. Burnham drives into the lane. His shot blocked by Swinton. But Ketch Jacobson is going to get the foul on the way up, and so that will send Burnham to the line. He'll be shooting 2. 16 fouls now on the Glacier Bears. That's Ketch's first. Burnham's first bounces off the rim about 4 or 5 times and drops through. He's got his first point of the game. cuts that Glacier Bird lead to one. 16-15, 7-13 left in the first half. Burnham's second one is up. This one's off the backrim, rebound to Green. Green, double team back there, gets it off to Cox. Cox quickly up ahead to Stegen. Stegen drives down the right-hand side. He's cut off, comes back up top to Cox. Cox going to back up and reset it here. He's got Burnham on him. Gets past him. Goes down to the lane. Kicks it out to Swinton out by the three-point line. Swinton's off the back rim. Rebound comes down to Jacobson, and we're going to have Trevor Cox over the back. And that's going to be third on Trevor. He's got to watch himself here. And quickly into the game is Cunningham. Trevor's got to be making better decisions out there because he had a reach that was blatant that they're going to call every time and out over the back when he really didn't. Jacobson had that ball, and that's not a – when you're the point guard, you can't be taking yourself out with 6:52 in the first half with three fouls, setting yourself on the bench. But, yeah, Jacobson will be going to the line because we're bonus both ways. That was a 17th foul on the Glacier Bears. So Jacobson, he's got four from the field, looking to get his first free throw, and he knocks that one down, earns the second. So we're tied now at 16 all with 6:52 left in the first half. Jacobson's second shot is up, and this one's nothing but net. Good-looking stroke from Jacobson, gives the Panthers a one-point lead. Stegen now on the dribble, goes up to Cunningham. Cunningham's pass is going to be stolen away. And let's see, we got a foul on the play. Foul's going to be on number one, Morgan House, his second personal. And that will send Swinton back to the line for the Glacier Bears. Charlie Blanc in for the Panthers. And also Brian Castle in for the Panthers. And House and Records will take a break. Swinton's first is up, rolls around, no good. Rebound controlled by Green. His shot misses. Rebound comes down the other way to Blanc. Blanc quickly up and loses control of the ball. Out of bounds. It will be back to the Glacier Bears. Panthers set up that full court press. Glacier Bears get it into Stegen. Slowly on dribble, goes right hand side to Green. Green back to Stegen. Stegen across the 10-second line. Now comes left hand side to Jacobson. Jacobson on the baseline to Swinton. Swinton, he's going to drive baseline, gets up. Reverse layup, he's a little bit short. Rebound comes down to Jacobson. 1 point lead for the Panthers. Jake Almanzor goes down to Blanc, and he's hacked by Cunningham. So that's Patrick's second personal foul. And that will send Charlie Blanc to the line for the first time tonight. Shooting two. Well, he seems to foul, and I think we're going to see a lot of free throws. Blanc's first is right down the middle. That's his first point of the game. Gives the Panthers a two-point lead. Now Hudson Sage coming off the bench for the Bears for Matthew Green. Blanc back at the free throw line for his second. Toes the line, three dribbles, shots up, and good. He's got two, that's a three-point lead now. Stegen on the dribble for the Glacier Bears. He passes it ahead to Jacobson. Jacobson stops, gets it back to Stegen. Stegen looking for a little help. Coming up on the right-hand side, he gets it to Swinton. Swinton double-teamed up top. He's going to drive through the double-team, picks it up, little scoop shot, nothing there. And we're going to get a foul, number 2-0 on the Panthers. That'll be Timber Burnham. That's going to be Timber's third personal foul. And 10 team fouls. So that's in Hudson Sage to the line, shooting two for the Glacier Bears. Hudson's got six in the game, leading scorer for the Bears. Good chance to earn a couple more at the line. Hudson's first is up and good.
We don't have any field goals yet in this quarter either.
Everything's been free throws. Now back into the game is Drew Marker. And Burnham will take the second one. Bounce out back room and drops for Hudson. So he's got game-high 8 points so far here in the first half. Glacier Bears back to within one. Quickly back is Marker up with the shot. Rebound comes down to Swinton. Swinton double-teamed in the backcourt. Gets to Cunningham. Cunningham to Stegen across the 10-second line. He's going to back it out, set up the offense. tries to get it to the baseline to Swinton, but that was a little far outside of his reach and had to step on the end line and turns it back over to the Panthers. Panthers doing a lot of reaching on these as the Glacier Bears are driving by. So far, they haven't been picking up many fouls on it, but Merker on the right-hand side comes up top to Castle. Castle left side, they reverse it down on the baseline. Shots up, no good. Rebound comes out long to Jacobson. Jacobson hands it off to Swinton. Swinton going to drive down the right-hand side, gets all the way in, leaves that one short too. Kind of forced that one, and now Swinton's going to pick up the foul. Compounding the problem here. You miss a layup and then get the foul. That'll be Gillen's first. And we'll be in a one-on-one situation going the other way with Brian Castle at the free throw line. To end of the game for the Glacier Bears, Green's in for Swinton. Swinton's had a couple drives there. I think he just needs to take one more dribble because he's trying to shoot the ball before he's all the way to the hoop, trying to get a little finger roll there. I think if he took one more dribble, another step, he'd have a lot better chance converting those layups.
It's tall enough, he can go hard to the hoop, you know, and lay it up in there.
So Castle makes his first.
I think he can shoot over everybody that's there.
Yep. And the next one is up and good. So Glacier Bears back against that full court press and stepping into it is Blanc, tipping it out of bounds. Glacier Bears will reset here. 5:03 left in the first half. They're trailing by 3, 21-18. Panthers still in that full court pressure. Green throws it up ahead to Sage. Sage across 10-second line to Jacobson. Jacobson to Cunningham. He misses the shot. Rebound down by Blanc. Great execution by the Glacier Bears up until the missed shot. Back the other way is going to be Castle. And we're going to get a traveling call on Castle as he goes to the hoop. Green looking for an inbounds, gets it over to Cunningham. Cunningham on the dribble, gets it across the 10-second line, gets it over to Sage. Sage is going to shoot the 18-foot, and he's going to be fouled on the shot. Number 4, Jacobson, his second personal. That'll send Sage back to the free throw line. 4:44 left in the first half. Hudson's shot is up, rolls around and drops through. 9 points for Hudson. And he'll be back at the line for his second. That shot is up. Back rim. Rebound comes down to Green. He has it stripped out of his hands by Almanzor. And then stolen away by Jacobson for the Glacier Bears. To Sage. Over to Green on the baseline. Green's going to drive the right baseline. Tries to dish it to Sage. Stolen away by the Panthers. Almanzor has it. He's across the 10-second line. Going to drive down the center of the lane. Little scoop shot. No good. Rebound through Cunningham's hands down to Castle. Castle's shot up. No good. Rebound by Cunningham. Cunningham on the dribble. He's going to hand it off to Stegen and let Stegen get the ball up the court. Coach Foster was telling him, push it up there. Don't be walking up the court. Get the left-hand side to catch Jacobson. To Cunningham. Down the baseline to Green. Green, power dribble. Goes up left side. Up and good for two. Matthew Green's got 6. And we're tied at 21. Quickly back is Burnham on the left side. Excuse me, that was Marker. Marker gets it to the shot. Rebound comes down to Stegens, and we're going to be tied up by Castle. Alternating possession will be to the Panthers. Off the bench for the Glacier Bears. You've got Fowler into the game for the first time, and Swinton back into the game. Sage and Green will take a seat. Now also Durr will check in for the first time, and he's coming in for Stegen. Into the game for the Panthers. House is coming in, and Jacobson will take a seat. Panthers get the ball in. Almanzor on the left baseline. Comes up top to House. House is going to shoot the three and drain it. Morgan House, he's got 5. Glacier Bears have Swinton bringing the ball up. Gets it ahead to Fowler. Fowler is going to travel with the ball. He's got either pass it or dribble it, Marty. Couldn't decide either one, so he took a couple steps. But first game jitters, that can be expected. Almanzor on the dribble across 10-second line for the Panthers. 2-3 zone for the Glacier Bears. Almanzor turns, spins, gets it up to Castle. Castle's going to drive in and miss a shot, but he's going to be fouled. by number one four, Zane Durr, his first personal foul. That's 10 team fouls on the Glacier Bears now. So the last 3:28 of the half, it'll be two shots each way. And Brian Castle will be back at the free throw line. He's 2 for 2. Make it 3 for 3. Castle's second is up, that was off the front rim. Rebound comes down to Swinton. Swinton pushing the ball up across the 10-second line. Gets all the way to the baseline, and he's going to be fouled by number 41, Castle. So Brian Castle is going to pick up his first personal. And that'll send Swinton to the line, shooting two. He's done a good job getting to the free throw line. Haven't had much luck making them. So 3:21 left, Panthers by 4, 25-21 here in the first half. Swinton's shots off the front rim. He's 1 for 6. These are points Glacier Bears need. And he misses that one as well. Quickly back is Marker. Marker across 10-second line. He's hounded by Cunningham. Cunningham quickly steals it from him, but it's right out of bounds. And now Sage will come in for a foul for the Glacier Bears. Panthers are going to be inbounding on the far right baseline here, all the way down at the end. Castle on the inbounds gets it into Marker. Marker, double teamed by Glacier Bears. Out to Castle for a three-point shot. Back rim rebound comes to Almanzor on the weak side. He turns over to Blanc. Blanc's shot is up and good for two. So Charlie Blanc's got four now. Swinton into Jacobson. Back to Swinton. Swinton up ahead to Sage. Sage turns, looks, gets it to Cunningham. Cunningham got a two-on-one situation. Goes in hard on the right side. Misses the shot. But we've got a foul on Green. 41. That'll be Brian Castle's second, and that will send Patrick Cunningham to the line shooting two. This will be his first two shots from the game. First shot is up. That was no good. Difference in the game so far. Both teams shooting a lot of free throws, just the Panthers are making more than we are. Nobody's really done a whole lot from the field, so this could come down to a free throw shooting contest. Cunningham, second one. That's front rim rebounded out by Marker. Marker up across 10-second line, drive in into the lane, passes it out to Vickers. Vickers shot. Rebound alongside to Almanzor. Almanzor to Castle. Castle up and good for two. Brian Castle's got five. Extending that lead to 8 now are the Panthers. Swinton comes up into the front court. Throws it long to Cunningham. Cunningham can't save it. And Glacier Bears not doing a real good job with the basketball with Trevor Cox out. Makes that those two fouls of his that really weren't the best mental decisions. All the more important, he's got to be able to stay in the game. Run this offense for the Bears. Marker comes in, gives it to House. House for a three-point shot. Long rebound by Castle. Castle's going to drive the right baseline, and he's going to be fouled by Cunningham with a push, and that's going to be 3 on Cunningham. And they'll send Castle to the line. He's 3 for 4 here in the second quarter from the line. Gets a chance for a couple more. 2:14 left in the first half. And that one's way short. Green going to check into the game for the Glacier Bears. He'll come in for Cunningham. So we got Durr, Jacobson, Swinton, Sage, and Green for the Glacier Bears. Sage down with the rebound. He has that strip, but he was fouled on the play. For the Panthers, we've got Almanzor, House, Castle, Vickers, and Marker. So now coming back the other way, that was House. That's his third personal. So you've got Burnham, House with 3, Castle with 2, Jacobson with 2, Vickers with 2 for the Glacier Bears, Cox with 3, and Cunningham with 3, and a bunch of guys with 1. So Sage's first is up and good. Hudson's got 10. He's doing a great job keeping the Glacier Bears in this one so far. Off the bench is Seth Parker for the Panthers, and he'll be giving House a break. I don't think we'll see House until the second half. Hudson Sage back at the line for another one. That one's long rebound. Hudson gets the rebound himself. Has his shot blocked out of bounds by Almanzor. But the Glacier Bears will retain possession. They'll inbounds on the baseline, right-hand side of the lane. Be Green triggering the inbounds. Get it into Jacobson. Jacobs up top to Durr, to Swinton. Swinton, three-point shot. Back rim, rebound by Sage. Sage fighting for it underneath. Goes up with a shot, and good. Hudson Sage has got 12. Cuts that lead to 5 with 1:55. Marker quickly back down to the right-hand side with the long three-point shot. Back rim comes out to Castle. Castle spins, has the ball out of his hands. It's picked up by Parker. Parker on the left wing, brings it up top to Almanzar. Almanzar is going to drive in, tries to go right hand side through Swinton's hands. It gets out to Marker. Marker kicks it back to Almanzar for an 18-footer, and that is good by Gabe Almanzar. He's got 6. Glacier Bears get it up to Swinton. Swinton tries to go ahead to Durr, but Durr wasn't looking for that one, right through his hands and out of bounds. Glacier Bears are doing the right thing on breaking the press. It's just the guys on the receiving end either aren't ready, or the Glacier Bears are throwing a little too long. But they're throwing the ball there in the right general direction. Hopefully we start converting on some of those. 2-3 zone for the Bears. Marker on the dribble up top. Goes left side to Castle. Now the Almonds are on the baseline. To Marker. Marker drives in, kicks it out to Castle. Castle with a set shot, 3, no good. Rebound comes to Almanzar. Almanzar to Castle. To Parker. Parker drives in and has it stolen away by Swinton. Swinton up ahead, and he's going to miss the layup. Marker down with the ball now. He's quickly into the front court, 52 seconds left in the first half. Marker drives into the lane, and a little 12-footer rolls around the rim, and good. To Marker with 6, and it's a 9-point lead for the Panthers. Swinton up on the right-hand side, gets up, leaves that shot a little bit short. Sage's follow is tipped and blocked. Quickly back the other way is Vickers. Vickers up and good with his shot. Zach Vickers has 2. Swinton up ahead to Sage. Sage turns, up fakes, up a shot that's long. Rebound comes out to Vickers. Vickers going to drive all the way in, and he's going to be fouled by Matthew Green. Matthew had plenty of time to get in front of him, but just kind of gave him a hip bump as he went by. That'll be Matthew's 2nd personal. Again, we're in the double bonus, and so that's going to send Vickers to the line, shooting 2. 12.9 seconds left. Panthers by 11. They're really stretching this out here towards the end of the second quarter. First one, front rim, no good. We foul in for the Glacier Bears. Glacier Bears 2 for 15 on the quarter, and the Panthers 6 for 21. So not much decent shooting on either side for this. Seth Waldo in for Matthew Green for these last 12.9 seconds here of the first half. Vickers at the line for his 2nd. That one drops for him. Glacier Bears tried to inbound it to Jacobson, and he wasn't even looking at the ball. Just a lot of early mistakes here for the Glacier Bears, where people just need to start paying attention to what they're doing on the court. It's all working in the Panthers' favor right now. Vickers gets in Almanzar, stolen away by Fowler. Fowler looking for an outlet. He's got the dribble, so he'll bring it up across the 10-second line. Gets it on the baseline to Jacobson. Jacobson's shot is long, and that will be the end of the first half with the Haines Glacier Bears 24 and Craig Panthers 36. We'll send it back to KRBB for about 8 minutes, and then we'll come back with a wrap-up of the second half and prepare you for wrap-up of the first half and prepare you for second half action. We'll be right back.
Jacobson, Marker, House, Blanc, Castle, they have all gotten on the scoreboard. Burnham picked up a couple there for the Panthers. So everybody's scoring on the Panthers' side. Hudson Sage is the big score for the Glacier Bears. He's got 12 points. It's going to be Glacier Bear basketball. Start this third quarter play here. Haines Glacier Bears 24, Craig Panthers 36. Green will inbound it for the far side. Green, Cox, Sage, Swinton out there, and also Jacobson. Catch Jacobson for the Glacier Bears starting the second half of play. Panthers shot back. They try to make the steal. They step inside. Is they going to get the ball back? No. Nice anticipation that time as House stepped out, was able to tap the ball, just wasn't able to control it, and it goes out of bounds. But he stepped into that passing lane and was on his way to the bucket. Back to Cox, just starting third quarter action now. Panthers drop back into a 2-3 zone defense also. They put a little bit of pressure on. They don't need to get anything out. Cox puts up the shot, and he's got it. So Trevor Cox picks up a couple of points. That's his sixth point of the evening. Glacier Bears down by 10 now. Panthers with the ball at the top. They're in the long shot, long three-pointer, no rebound, fought for. Sage comes away with it. Glacier Bears are also in a 2-3 zone defense. Panthers are not putting a lot of pressure on. They go to catch Jacobson, who turned around to try to give the ball to Sage, but it was out in front of him, goes out of bounds. Ball goes back to the Craig Panthers. Panthers will inbound the basketball. No pressure being applied by either team. I think both coaches probably figure we can't afford to do that right now. We got so many fouls out there. They go right-hand side. Glacier Bears a 2-3 zone. We're way beyond the three-point arc. The Panthers are over the House. Takes a couple dribbles along the baseline. Wanted to go inside, but partially tapped away that time as Vickers wasn't able to get it. And Glacier Bears make the steal, and they'll come up the court. Panthers drop back in a 2-3 zone. Some pressure being applied, but Cox way out beyond the three-point arc here. Now they extend it out just a bit, though, and put some pressure on was Marker, but he drops it back. Now they go to Jacobson, baseline right-hand side to Swinton. Stops, wants to go inside to Green. Nice pass, Green, up and in. Nice pass that time by Swinton as he got his man to come to him. Green came across the baseline. Swinton just kind of dipped it off to him, and he laid it up and in. Well, they're going to take a full timeout here as the Panthers need one here to talk about it. We're going to turn it back to KRBD. We'll be back in 1 minute.
A little better ball movement that now. But, you know, they're playing zone. If she can get through this quarter with that, she'll go back to man-to-man again.
Now, welcome back to the Carl Ward Gymnasium here. Craig Panthers are out of that timeout first as they come out quick. They've changed it up to get into that 2-3 zone defense. Probably coach didn't want him to pick up any more fouls as both teams were doing a lot of fouling there. And now the Panthers will have the basketball far side, 36-28. They'll come back out to the top as Marker. He'll bring the ball to the left-hand side. Just a slow dribble, no pressure being applied. Now they'll go right-hand side to Jacobson. He comes across, reverses it back, steps up, going to the center lane. Up goes the shot, and there's going to be an offensive foul on Burnham. Went hard to the hoop, and is going to be able to not draw the foul, but he's going to get the charging foul, so it is going to be on him, and that'll be his fourth, so he'll be right back out of the ball game. And that definitely is going to hurt the Panthers there. 6:21 to go here, third quarter of play. Glacier Bears with the basketball. Cox, a little pressure being applied out the top by Marker. Cox reverses it back around to Swinton, wants the baseline. Jumper from about six, in and out. No, gets his own board back, fights up underneath. Up and a little bit short on the rebound, still gets up with it. There's Swinton, and he's going to be fouled. Swinton came up with a nice board that side on the inside there, just couldn't get it to go. Foul's going to be on the Panthers. And that foul is on, well, they haven't put it up there yet. It's going to send Swinton to the free throw line here. I don't want to talk about Swinton's free throws because he needs to make one, and he finally does. So he's got two free throws and only 2 points in the ball game. Sweating a little chance. I'm not sure who that foul was on. They still haven't got it up there. Swinton shot, no rebound, fought for underneath, controlled by Green. Now there's going to be a quick timeout as Green had the basketball, and coach was there to call it out. Green came down with that board, but was kind of out of control. It's going to be only a 30-second timeout, so we're going to keep it here. But a lot of scrapping by the Panthers. They get right after it.
Yep, like we were talking during halftime about some of the difference in the game. You know, we're talking about the free throw shooting where the Panthers were 11 for 16, the Ghost Bears 6 for 17 from the line there in that first half. But one of the things is just the hustle, you know, the loose balls and everything. It seems Craig is a little more adamant about going for those than some of the Ghost Bears.
Well, and you've brought it up a couple of different times. As soon as they put that shot up, they're crushing the boards. And so they're taking away a lot of opportunities for the Glacier Bears to come away with a rebound just by playing hustle. Glacier Bears are going to have the basketball on their end of the court. Right-hand side, they'll set it up. Green with the ball, holding high over his head. They've gotten some good shots out of this lately. Back to Cox. Comes back over side to Swinton. They try to go inside to Sage off of his hands. That would have been the shot for Dillon to put up because there was nobody around. He was only about 6 or 8 feet from the bucket. Hudson was a little too far underneath.
Well, I think Hudson was expecting him to shoot that one also.
Panthers with the basketball, bring it up. 36-29, Panthers with the lead. Goes down in the court, puts up the shot a little bit short. Rebound fought for underneath, goes out of bounds off of, I think, one of the Glacier Bears. Going hard to the hoop was Marker. Put it up too hard off the glass, though, and came back down and fought for underneath. Goes off one of the Glacier Bears. And inbound, inbound, inbound. Now they finally get it inside. They're stolen away by Swinton as he stepped in the lane. He's on the dribble, goes down the right-hand side, puts his head down and goes. Green 4-1. That'll be Castle. That'll be his third personal foul. So the Panthers getting a bit more foul trouble here. Glacier Bears with the basketball. Cox, 5:39 to go here in the third quarter. Cox goes left-hand side, kicks it out to Swinton. Takes a couple of dribbles, looks at the basket. Then he comes back to Jacobson all the way over to Cox. Puts it up, in and out. No rebound, fought for underneath. Coming away with it nicely that time was Castle. And he's on the dribble. He's going all the way to the hoop. Puts up the shot. Nothing there. Going to be a whistle on it. Going to be an offensive charge on 4-1. He just went right straight to the hoop. I'm not sure what he had in mind because there were three Glacier Bears standing there. There was no way he was going to get to the hoop. So that's his fourth, but he's going to stay in the ball game. Goes back out to Jacobson, over to Swinton, left-hand side. Zone defense by the Panthers right now. They'll send it back out. 36-29, 5 minutes to go here in the third quarter. Over to Jacobson. Green posting up inside. Now he goes inside, almost knocked away by the Panthers. Fight for underneath, going to be tied up as Hudson Sage came out. Ball's going to go to the Craig Panthers off of that tie-up. Almanzoro inbound right here in front of the scorer's bench. He'll get the ball into the marker. Not a lot of scoring so far here in this third quarter of play here. Comes back out of the top. Marker wants to go down the lane. He'll kick it back out. They reverse it back around. Nice passing that time by the Panthers. They'll come back out to the top to Castle. Going down the lane, putting up the shot. Kind of out of control was that shot by Jacobson. Going to be a whistle on the play, however. Going to be on number four, Jacobson. And that'll be his third personal foul. Five team fouls on the Panthers right now. He's out to Cox, will bring it up. Glacier Bears can get a score here, tighten this game up a little more. They go to Swinton. Swinton tries to drive inside, nothing going, however, as they got a hand on it, but Green is able to come away with it. Cox down the lane, stops, puts up the shot from about six, rolls around, and in. Trevor Cox has picked up his eighth point of the evening. Quickly down the court come the Panthers, and all the way around his marker. Stops, puts up the shot from about six, and he's got it. He just kept going around and around until he found an open spot and put up the shot. 7-point lead by the Panthers. Long down court pass to Swinton. He wants the baseline. They try to go inside. Almanzor gets a hand on it back to Swinton. Puts it up. Going to be checked on it. Right corner underneath. Going to be a whistle. Foul's going to be on 3-2. That's Hudson Sage. That'll be his second personal foul. First team foul on the Glacier Bears. Panthers will bring the ball up. They lead by 7. 3:51 to go here in the third quarter. Marker on the dribble. Goes right. Goes down the center lane. Puts up the shot. A little bit short off the iron. Fought four underneath. Tapped out. Who's going to come away with it? Swenton does, but I think he's going to be fouled by Almanzer over on the far side. It is going to be Almanzor on the far side. He picks up his second personal foul. 16 foul on the Panthers. Glacier Bears are going to get to the free throw line now if they can just take advantage here. Green over to Cox. A little bit of pressure being applied at half court, but not a lot. Almost knocked away. Now there's going to be where he's kicking the ball. Cox already lost the dribble on it, but fortunately for the Glacier Bears, he kicked the ball because it would have been an easy lay-in for Records as he had the steal. Coming off the bench is Stegan. Looks like Cox is going to take a quick seat. Jacobson get the ball into Almanzor. He'll swing it slowly up across the half-court line. Wants to go right, goes down the center lane, puts his head down. Going to be tapped around. Ball is going to go off of one of the Glacier Bears and out of bounds. A lot of bumps and banging down through that lane that time. 3:26 to go here in the third quarter. Jacobson looking, looks for Almanzor's. Turn around. He wants the shot. Doesn't get it. Forces it up. Going to be checked. Gets his own ball back. Kicks the ball back out. Shot's on its way. And good by Jacobson. There's a three. And he's got 9 points so far this evening. Extends that lead back to 10 points again. They go to Green. Goes through his hands and out of bounds. Glacier Bears turning the ball over way too many times here. Almanzor will inbound it. Far side at the half-court line. Gets it into Jacobson. Jacobson will bring it up. Turns around, gives the ball back to Almanzor. Zone defense by the Glacier Bears. Swenton puts a little pressure on out the top. They go right-hand side. Long 3-0. Rebound fought for underneath. Green comes up with it. As Records put that shot up, it was a little too hard off the iron. Comes back to Swenton. Swenton gets the ball back into Green, right-hand side. Gives it back to Swenton down the lane. Puts his head down and puts up the shot too hard. Hudson Sage comes up with it, up and in. So Hudson Sage on the weak side picked up his 14th point as Swenton put it up hard, too hard off the glass. But Hudson hustled right in there, got good position, put it up and in, and drew the foul. So that'll put the Glacier Bears at the free throw line from now on. That's the 17th foul on the Craig Panthers. And that'll be the third personal foul on Almanzor. 2:44 to go here in the third quarter of play. Sage is shot in, out, no rebound, fought for, thrown away by Green, but he loses control of it. And goes out of bounds, so the Craig Panthers will come up with it. They lead by 8. Slowly up the court comes Records. He takes the dribble right, goes down the center of the lane, wants to kick it back out, going to be tapped away, however, Stegan, but now there's going to be a foul again on Castle. If that's the case, that'll be it for Castle, and he's going to foul out of the ball game with 5 points, 3 of those coming from the free throw line. So Brian Castle is going to take a seat for the rest of the evening here. Coming off the bench is Blanc. So Glacier Bears. Panthers are going to spread it out a little bit. The top. Jacobson spins back around. Almost loses the dribble. Now they go right-hand side to Blanc. Blanc goes down the lane. He'll bring it back out to the top. Here's Jacobson. Green puts a lot of pressure on Jacobson. Goes down the lane. Stops. Puts up the shot. Going to be a whistle on it. They're trying to do is spread it out, it looks like to me here, and get that lane going here. Foul's going to be on Hudson Sage, and that'll be his third personal foul. Panthers with the ball, left-hand side. Waiting, still looking, can't find a ball. They try to go inside. Almanzor stolen away nicely by Green, however. On the inbound, quickly down to Cox. But he earns the ball back over. Comes back in, having a hard time controlling, however. Almanzor all the way over and bringing the ball back out. It'll be Jacobson to set it up. 1:48 to go. Jacobson on the dribble. Gives it up. Goes to back to Blanc. Back to Jacobson. Green puts a lot of pressure on. Getting a bit whistled for the foul pretty quickly. Doesn't give him a little space. Comes down, puts up the shot, and draws the foul on Sage. Nice play by Vickers that time as he had Sage there, recognizing that Sage had that third foul, and that'll be his fourth foul. So That's going to send Vickers to the free throw line. He is one for two, has 3 points in the ball game. 1:34 to go here. 41 Craig, 34 Glacier Bears.
Jacobson's going to want to be careful with those elbows because he's moving those pretty high, trying to clear Green out the away from him if he doesn't have to connect with one of those for that to be a flagrant.
That's right. Well, between the two, they're trying to take a space of one.
Yep.
Vickers, 2 for 3 from the line. This one's on its way and is good. So he puts up another one from the free throw line, and that's his fifth point. 43-34. Greg, the Haines Glacier Bears, they try to go back inside to Cunningham, who checked into it. Bounces a little bit too. The pass was just a little bit too low. Wasn't able to get it. However, it goes out of bounds. About 1:28 to go here in the third quarter. The Panthers with the basketball, leading 43-34. Almanzor slowly comes up, still not across the half court line. Now he steps across, wants to go down the center of the lane, loses his dribble, kicks the ball back out. Nice hustle over there by Blanc as he's able to get it. Back out to Almanzor, they'll come around and get it over to Jacobson. Jacobson's out at the top, ball of his foot. I'm not sure what they're going to do here because the ball is handled. Back and forth, they kick the ball back in. And Blanc goes well over to Almanzor. He wanted to go inside. He should have taken the dribble inside. Coming up with it. There's Rickers about to put up the shot. Going to be a jump ball on as they tried to go up here. Jacobson wanted to go. A little bit of hectic here the last minute play here. Both teams just really scrambling after it. And no real offense set up here. Jacobson comes in. Green will come out. 52.7 seconds to go here in the third quarter. Looks like the Panthers are going to come out and put a little bit of pressure on now that they don't have Cox in there handling the basketball at the top. Now they go outside. Swinton all along. Going to be a whistle on it. As Almanzor is going to be whistled for his fourth personal foul. And now a technical also. That may be it for him. So that would be it for Almanzor, or he's going to foul out of the basketball game. I don't know what he said, but the official was right there, and I think it must have been pretty easy to determine that that was going to be a technical foul. So Glacier Bears are going to be at the free throw lines, 43-34. So we've got Stegen out there at the free throw line right now. See who's going to come off the bench for the Panthers here. Panthers are definitely getting themselves into foul trouble. Almanzor's out of the ballgame. Castle's out of the ballgame now. So the Glacier Bears need to take advantage of that. 43-34, 44 seconds to go here in the third quarter. Still trying to sort things out here. Who's shooting what here? 10 team fouls on the Craig Panthers. Looks like it's going to be Swinton at the free throw line.
He gets the two for a shot.
Two for the shot, and then we'll see who's going to shoot the technical. Well, maybe Dillon can make a few here, get himself back into good graces, and he'll get a chance to shoot the technical. And he got one out of two to go. So who's going to shoot the technical? Stegen looks like he's going to be shooting the technical for the Glacier Bears. Jacob Stegen, 1 for 2 from the free throw line. That's his only point of the ball game. This one's up on its way, rolls around, comes off to the side. No. Glacier Bears really struggling from the free throw line tonight. Bounces a couple more times. This one's up on its way, and this one is good. So he gets... He's 2 for 4, got both those points coming from the free throw line. It's going to be Glacier Bear basketball on the far side of the court. Well, the Glacier Bears are getting themselves back into the ball game here because the Panthers are getting themselves into foul trouble. Glacier Bears, far side. Panthers coming out in a man-to-man defense with 44 seconds to go here in the third quarter. They go to Stegen. Stegen's on the dribble. A lot of pressure being applied by Jacobson, but Stegen's able to handle it. Now they go cross-court to Cox. Long three on the way. Good. Trevor Cox, that's his first three, and he's got 11 points of the evening. Down to a four-point lead for the Craig Panthers, and they have the basketball. Goes right-hand side on the dribble. Nothing going, however, as Marker is able to get the ball back off to Jacobson. Back out to the top, as they go over to records. They just play a little bit, 14 seconds to go. Down the lane, want to put up the shot, goes up inside, up and no, doesn't get it to go. As breaking the hoop nicely off that pass was Vickers, just wasn't able to get it to go, but there's going to be a foul on it. As he goes to the free throw line, the foul's going to be on number 21. That'll be Stegen. That'll be his first personal foul. That was a nice play that time by the Panthers as they penetrated inside. As soon as the defense came to him, he dished it off to Vickers. Vickers at the free throw line. This one is good. So Vickers continues to do well from the free throw line as he's got four of his five from there, and he has 6 points in the ballgame. Bounces a couple line, 10 seconds. Grocery Bears have chance here. Shot is good. Picks up another one from the free throw line, and that's seven. The inbound is Stegen. 9 seconds. Long pass down to Cunningham. Takes a couple dribbles, stops, looks, can't find anybody. Ball goes around. Going to be a jump ball with 2.7 seconds to go. Going to be Panthers basketball, so they're going to have a chance now to get up a shot. 2.7, it'll be a pretty quick shot. We'll see where they're going to go with the basketball here. Takes a couple dribbles, stops, puts it up, it'll count. Nope, too hard off the glass. So we're going to end this third quarter of play with the Haines Glacier Bears 39 points and the visiting Craig Panthers 45. We're going to turn it back to KRBD for 1 minute. We'll be back in 1 minute. If Haines will just settle down for just a little bit, you know, if they get in this helter-skelter thing, they can't play with these guys.
Nope.
And they're in such foul trouble now that if they don't take advantage of it.
Yeah, Burnham's got four, Jacobson's got three, House has three.
Yeah, so, I mean, they're in trouble.
Okay, welcome back to Caldwell Gymnasium in Haines. Getting ready for fourth quarter action with the Craig Panthers and Haines Glacier Bears. Panthers lead going into this fourth quarter, 45-39, but they've lost two of their subs, and Almanzor and Castle have fouled out with five apiece. Burnham has three, Jacobson has three, House has three for the Glacier Bears. Sage has four, Cox has three, and Cunningham has three. It'll be Glacier Bear basketball to start the fourth quarter. Jacobson for the Glacier Bears gets it into Stegen. Stegen up across 10-second line. Pressure by the Panthers. Stegen goes right-hand side to Cox. Cox now on the dribble. He's got marker on him. Goes left side to Stegen. Stegen looks down on the baseline to Jacobson. Jacobson with the left hand. No. Rebound by Marker. Marker quickly up into the front court for the Panthers. Down on the right baseline to House. Up to Marker. Marker's going to drive into the lane. Stops, kicks it out to Burnham. Burnham up top to Jacobson. And House for three. Morgan House with a three-pointer. Gets that lead back up to nine. Stegen back on the dribble. He has it picked, but that was a kick ball. And so Glacier Bears will inbound again. Not sure I agree with Coach Bossman here, having Stegen bring up the ball instead of Cox. And Jacobson throws it right to Jacobson, but unfortunately, even though they have the same name, they're not on the same team. So Jacobson for the Panthers gets it to House on the left wing. He hands it back up to Jacobson, to Burnham, Burnham to Jacobson. And that's going to be a travel, a couple big steps there as he was trying to fake. Did a good job with the fake, but not legal. The end of the game for the Glacier Bears is going to be Sage coming in for Cunningham. And so Swinton's going to be coming in up to the front court looking for something. Jacobson gets it to Stegen. Stegen doesn't have anybody between him. He's going to dribble up on the right-hand side. Goes down to the baseline. Now he'll bring it up. Gives it to catch Jacobson. Catch goes right-hand side to Stegen. Stegen goes into Sage. Sage power dribble up and good for two. Hudson Sage has 16, cuts that lead back to 7. House quickly up, he's guarded by Swinton, comes up top to Burnham.
Burnham right hand side to Jacobson. Jacobson shot long. Rebound to Burnham. Burnham drives, stolen away by Swinton. Swinton up ahead. He's got House following him from behind. And Swinton's going to go up for the layup, and he's going to be fouled by House with the blocking foul running alongside of him. So that'd be Morgan House. That's four on him. Sends Swinton back to the free throw line. 4-2. Been Dylan's house of horrors here. He's done a great job getting to the free throw line, but he's been struggling to knock him down. This one goes through. That's four for him. All this from the free throw line. Number three, Isaiah Ruckins back into the game for Jacobson for the Panthers. Swinton's second one is up and good. Burnham on the go before the Panthers gets it across 10-second line. He's left-hand side of the lane. He's going to drive, and it'll be a kick ball off of Stegen. Tried to give it to Marker down the baseline. Good defense by Stegen cutting off that passing lane. Now Burnham will inbound on the sideline, just below the Craig bench. Looking for somebody, throws it way up top to Marker. Marker on the dribble against Stegen. Marker is going to get into the lane, kicks it out to House for three, and that's off front run. Rebound comes down to Marker. Marker up with the shot, and he's hammered by Sage. Sage went for the block shot and kind of followed through and got him with his body, so that'll send Drew Marker to the line. Shooting two, and that'll be Sage's. That's Sage's fifth. He's been the big scorer for the Glacier Bears with 16, so they're going to have to find some offense from somebody else here in the last 6-13. Only trailing by five. Cunningham will be in for Sage. And Drew Marker at the line looking for a chance to extend this Panther lead. First shot is up and good. He's got nine on the game for the Panthers. Second one is up. Rebound comes down by Swinton. Swinton's got somebody coming behind him to steal it. And it's off of Swinton's leg and out of bounds. And Coach Fossils want to know how come they're not calling any of three or four fouls against Swinton. Hacking him on the arms, but it'll be Glacier Bear basketball. I thought that went off of Swinton's leg. Glacier Bear's got a break on that one. Cunningham tries to drive down the right-hand side. And kind of lost control of the ball, but he was lucky enough on his, I think he was trying to pass it, but he threw it off one of the Panthers and out of bounds. That was probably better than where the pass was going to end up. Catch Jacobson inbounding for the Bears. Looking into it, gets to Cunningham on the left side. Oh, Patrick got a wide open. This is a layup. Rebound down by House. House quickly up into the front court for the Panthers. Goes right hand side to Marker. Marker to House. House eyed the three-pointer. Now he's going to drive against Swinton. Gets it off the glass. And good. So that'll be two more for House. 3-3, Swinton going to get the foul. So that's House's 10th point now. Second foul on Swinton. And Morgan House will be going to the line. This will be his first opportunities from the line so far in the game. It'll be a full timeout for the Glacier Bears. So we'll send it back to the studios of KRBD for 1 minute.
Well, I don't know what to say. I just don't know what to say. It just is so happening. I mean, I don't know what to say. I want to say junior high.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, that's kind of a lot.
Glacier Bear and Panther basketball on KRBD. We got 5:52 left in the game. Panthers by 8. And Morgan House will be going to the line shooting 2. He's got 10 points so far on the game. This will be his first two opportunities from the free throw line. Looking to stretch that Panther lead up to 10. First one, I guess they're saying that wasn't on the shot. They're only giving him one.
And he missed that one. Rebound for the Glacier Bears. Went down on the right-hand baseline. Looking for some help. Gets it off to Cunningham. Cunningham baseline to Stegen. Stegen inside the swing. Swing turns. Makes a little room and up in good for two. Dylan finally got one from the field there. He's got seven, and it's a six-point lead for the Panthers. Marker back. He's going to drive into the lane, high off the backboard, and rebound down by Cunningham. Cunningham gets it to Swinton. Swinton's got Marker picking him up. Swinton gets it over to Cunningham. Cunningham tries to get it in to Jacobson, and it's kicked by one of the Panthers. I don't know if that's the best thing to do, to give it to the shortest guy on the court down on the baseline in the paint. The Glacier Bears will be inbounding on their baseline. Catch Jacobson. Looking for an outlet. Gets it to Cox. Cox with a three-point shot. Rims in and out. Rebound comes down to Marker for the Panthers. Panthers quickly up into the front court. Marker's going to drive down the baseline and off the glass and good for two. Drew Marker's got 11 and leads back up to eight. Cox down on the right-hand side for the Glacier Bears. Cut off on the baseline. Looking for a little help. Gets it inside to Swinton. Swinton's going to muscle it up on the right side. Up and good for two. He's got nine. Glacier Bears looking to get a stop. The right-hand side to Records. Rebound of his shot is to Jacobson. Up ahead to Stegen. Stegen up on the right-hand side. His shot is up and good for Jacob Stegen. He's got four, and we've got a four-point ball game with 4.5 minutes left here in the quarter. Panthers come up to House. House is going to let fly from three, and that's money. Nice answer by Morgan House for the Panthers. He's got 13, lead up to seven. Swinton comes back the other way and dribbles it off the side of his leg. None of the officials saw what happened, but they looked to me like Swinton got that off of his leg, and so they're going to give the ball to the Panthers. These guys always try and, they've got somebody pressuring them. And instead, if the person's not in front of them, instead of trying to cut back in, you know, they just keep trying to go up, try and go up the lane and just run themselves out of bounds. Marker over to Blanc, and Blanc up and good for two. Back up to nine is the Panther lead. Swinton comes up, goes to Stegen. Stegen down on the baseline to Cunningham. Cunningham on the baseline to Jacobson. His shot is swatted by Burnham. Burnham to Blanc. Blanc, right-hand side. Marker for three, and that's money for Marker. Drew Marker, he's got 14, and it's a 12-point lead now for the Panthers. Swinton comes up across the 10-second line. We're going to get a timeout for the Glacier Bears. Coach Fossman sees this one. They had it down to four, and now it's up to 12 in a blink of an eye here, about 35 seconds. And it'll be a full timeout, so we'll send it back to the KRBD studios for 1 minute.
Stops, but they don't really, I mean, these guys, but they don't run any time off the clock, so they go right to the hoop all the time, but
welcome back to Haines. Glacier Bears inbound, and it'll be Matthew Green gets it up to Trevor Cox. Trevor up high, man-to-man defense by the Panthers. Trevor goes down and tries to get it into Swift, but he was double-teamed. Stolen away by Vernon. And then back stolen away by Cox. Cox gets drive down the right-hand side, gives it over to Swift. Swift up on the left, leaves it a little bit short, gets his own rebound, goes back up again, and he's going to be fouled. And let's see which one of the Panthers they're going to call this on. There's three of them around him. Number one, that's going to be House. That's five on House. And he's done for the day. And we're going to have Zach Vickers
checking into the game for the Panthers. Now, there's a lot of times that basketball can be a really beautiful game with a lot of flow and everything to it. Tonight is not one of those nights. This has been an ugly game both ways. A lot of fouls, a lot of turnovers. A lot of mental errors by both teams.
Early in the season.
Early in the season. It can only get better. Swinton misses another free throw. Can only get better from here. Swinton's second one is up. That one's short rim, rebound. Grace Bush fighting each other for it. Matthew Green will come away with it, and he's going to travel. Jacobson, he's going to get it into Marker. Grace Bush aren't putting any full court pressure on him. Marker going to drive in, tries to kick it off, is stolen away by Stegen. Stegen looks up ahead to Cox. Cox, nothing there. He's going to take the three-point shot, and that's going to be good for Trevor Cox. He's got 14. Grace Bush need to get a stop. Marker goes up top to Burnham. Burnham looks to Vickers. Ball stolen away. Nope. Kicked it right back to Vickers, and we got a timeout for the Panthers. 30-second timeout, so we'll keep this one here. 2:48 left in the game. Panthers have a 9-point lead, and the way that they can put up some points, it seemed like it's pretty safe, but then, like that last time, they came down and turned it right over, and the Grocery Bears get a bucket at the other end.
Well, I'm sure Coach is going to talk a little bit about, you know, being a little more patient on the offense, but they don't want to just back it back out because, you know, they're making too many mistakes, and Grocery Bears are going to overplay right now. So, on the other hand, the Grocery Bears, they're going to come out and put some pressure on. They don't want to give up an easy bucket, though. So, a lot of things can happen in this last couple, 3 minutes here, but I'm sure the Panthers want to talk about a little bit because, like Doug said, they probably didn't run 10 seconds off of that before they had to turn it over. Yeah, 2:48 to go here in the fourth quarter. 61-52. Panthers have the basketball on the timeout here.
So the Panthers inbounding on the far side. Grocery Bears picking up close here, trying to get it in, looking, and they get it in to Blanc. Blanc tries to come cross court to Marker. Marker's going to drive left baseline, gets it over to Vickers, and Vickers is going to be hammered by Swinton, so that'll be Swinton's third. And we're in a one-on-one switch situation here. Grocery Bears 12 for 29 so far from the free throw line. 17 points they've left in a 9-point game. I think free throw shooting probably going to be on their practice schedule here this next week. Zach Vickers at the line. His first one is back rim, no good. He's got a second one coming. Vickers' second shot is up, and that one, long rebound comes out to Stegen. Stegen on the dribble. Gets it across the 10-second line. Drops down the baseline to Green. Green's going to go up with the shot. Leaves it long. Rebound on the weak side by Cunningham. Cunningham shot no good. Rebound by Vickers. Grocery Bears having some opportunities. Just need to convert them. Quickly back the other way. They get it to Jacobson. Jacobson pulls it out towards half court. He's picked up by Cunningham. Cunningham's going to foul him. He doesn't need to push it. Coach Fossey was telling him to foul him. He got the foul, and he kind of just shoved him after that. This is his first year of really playing any basketball, so I think Coach Fossman's probably going to give him a little heads up on. They're debating that right now, whether they're going to call an intentional foul on that. So, and it won't be an intentional. And Coach is asking why, so Smith Clay comes over and talk to him. So we got a one-on-one situation for the Panthers. And it should be Jacobson that'll be shooting the free throws for the Panthers. It'll be a one-on-one situation. Grocery Bears have 8 personal fouls. And that one is good. So Jacobson 3 for 3 so far from the free throw line. He's got 10 points. Second one off. Rebound down by Green for the Grocery Bears. Swinton coming up ahead. Cox. Cox for 3. Back rim. Fighting for the rebound. Off of one of the Panthers, I thought. And it will be Grocery Bears basketball. Off the bench is Parker for the Panthers. He'll be coming in for Blanc. Green on the inbounds for the Grocery Bears on the baseline. He's got Swinton, Cox, Stegen, and Cunningham with him. Oh, they have Cunningham wide open. They go out to Cox. Cox's 3 is front rim short. Rebound comes down to Jacobson. Jacobson up into the front court. They're just picking him up. Now they go over to Marker. Marker hounded by Stegen. Marker's going to get into the lane, and he throws it wide, but he's going to be grabbed by Stegen. That's partially why his pass was a little wide. So it'll be Stegen's second personal. Glacier Bears down by 10 with 1:51 left, and we're going to be sending Drew Marker to the line. This will still be a one-on-one situation. Marker's got 14, leading scorer for the Panthers. And that one's short, rebound by Swinton. Swinton up ahead to Cox on the left side. Cox going to drive down, kicks it out to Swinton. Swinton looked at the three-pointer, wasn't there, gives it back out to Cox. Glacier Bears need to get some points in a hurry. Cox is going to go down the left-hand side, hands it off to Green. Green up and good for two on the right side. Matthew Green has 10. We're down to an 8-point lead with 90 seconds left in the game. Burnham on the dribble, guarded by Swinton. Burnham comes up top to Jacobson, stolen away by Cunningham, and we're going to get a timeout for the Glacier Bears, and Cunningham came with the ball. It'll be a full timeout, so with a minute left, 19 left, we'll send it back to KRBD for a full timeout. 1 minute.
At least KRBD is on top of it anyway.
Left in the fourth quarter, the visiting Craig Panthers 62, Glacier Bears 54. It'll be Glacier Bear basketball. And Panthers coming out with some pressure here. Get it to Cox. Cox out to Stegen. Stegen up fakes. Now he lets fly from three. That one's long. Rebound comes out to Swinton, and Swinton's going to be fouled by Parker. They'll send Swinton at the line for two. That hasn't been his favorite spot for today. Got a chance here to cut into this lead with the clock stop, though. First one is good. Swinton has 10, cuts that lead to 7. And that one's good, too. Cuts it down to 6-point lead for the Panthers. There's goes a little token pressure. So you got Burnham on the dribble, got guarded by Swinton. Burnham's going to get past Swinton. And we got a timeout by the Panthers right before we're going to have a held ball. And let's see if we've got what it is that we've got left, or 4:30. Going to be a full timeout, so they'll send it back to KLBB for another minute. Welcome back to Haines. 62-56 is the score. Panthers by 6. Out on the court to finish it up here, we've got Marker, Vickers, Parker, Burnham, and Jacobson. For the Glacier Bears, we have Swinton, Cox, Stegen, Cunningham, and Green. Panthers will be inbounding on their baseline. Got Jacobson looking up top to Marker. Marker on the dribble. He's guarded by Stegen. Marker gets passive, drives in the lane, up with the shot, off the backboard, and good for two. 16 for Marker. Grace Bears throw it up ahead, but Matthew Green throws that about four rows up in the bleachers. Not a good pass by Green that time. He had Glacier Bear open, but just to the wide right. So Panthers get it in to Burnham. Burnham guarded by Swinton. Burnham has the ball kicked away. Gets it back from Marker. Burnham down, stolen away, almost stolen by the Glacier Bears. Parker's on the floor for it. Swinton's going to try and come away with it, and we're going to get a foul for Jacobson. That's his fourth personal. Madison Swinton back to the line, shooting another two free throws. This will be his 17th and 18th attempt from the free throw line in the game. I've never seen that many free throw attempts by one person.
Well, it's nice to get that attempt,
but he needs to make them. He's only made seven of them so far.
It's not even 50%, is it?
Nope. And that one's not going to help him get anywhere closer to 50%. So 8-point lead for the Panthers with 34.4 seconds left. Swinton's second shot. That one rattles and drops for him. So he's got 12. And that ball's going to go back to the Glacier Bears. Kicked off one of the Panthers. So down seven, 29 and a half seconds left. Glacier Bears working against, they do have one left. Panthers had, that's going to be their last timeout. I was looking on the wrong side of the score clock there. So 30-second timeout for the Craig Panthers. 29 and a half seconds left. They lead by seven. Glacier Bears have to go the length of the court, and Panthers were showing full court pressure to allow.
Well, yeah, and I think probably coach just wanted to get him to settle down a little bit, use a little bit more time. They had the basketball in their hands there, and coming down and Parker going down that right-hand side just kept the dribble alive. He could have stopped, pivoted back, you know, and then found somebody else to give the ball to. But, you know, it's just little things that you've got to do. This time of the year, things will get better as the season goes along, though.
We hope. So you've got Green and Swinton in the backcourt looking to inbounds the pass. Green gets it in to Swinton. Swinton's going to come up the right-hand side. And he briefly loses control of the ball. Cox gets it. Cox looking for a shot. He's going to take the three and make it. Trevor Cox, he's got 17, cuts it to four, quickly up the head to Parker. Parker has the ball stolen out of his hands, but Swinton couldn't grab it before he goes off the end line. And why Parker was trying to go to the basket there instead of just maintaining control and running some clock. I think we're both shaking our heads. Wow. Victor's will be inbounding. He gets it into Blanc. Fossman was calling for a foul for his team there, and they finally got it. So I'll send Charlie Blanc to the line. That'll be Swinton's fourth personal foul. And Blanc will be at the line. He's 2 for 2 from the free throw line so far. He's got 6 points. And 10.2 seconds if he makes the full up. Back rim, front rim, and off. And Glacier Bear is going to have to hope he misses this one, try and get a rebound and go long for a three. Second one is good, so that gives them a 5-point lead, so it's going to make things difficult for the Glacier Bears. Swinton quickly up into the front court. Gets it to Cox on the baseline. Cox's three is long. Rebound comes down to Blanc, and we're going to get him fouled with half a second left. That's going to be our ball game, but we got some free throws to shoot for Charlie Blanc. Let's see which one of the Glacier Bears, Jacob Stegen, that's going to be his third personal. So right now it's 65-60 lead for the Panthers with half a second left. I think the only deciding is going to be the margin of victory because we've got Blanc at the line for two to see what our final margin is going to be. Glacier Bears is going to look back at this and 14 for 33, I think, from the free throw line is going to be the final tally. Blanc misses his first. And to lose a game by 5 or 6 with missing double-digit free throws. I think both teams, I would expect both teams to come out and play better tomorrow. This is a pretty scrappy, crazy game. Rebound comes down to Green, and that's going to be the horn, our final. 65-60. The Panthers get the win. Final scoring, Matthew Green for the Glacier Bears with 10. Trevor Cox with a game-high 17. Jacob Stegen with 4. Dylan Swinton with 12. Hudson Sage, he carried the Glacier Bears with that 16 until he ran into foul trouble and had to sit down for most of the fourth quarter. Scoring for the Craig Panthers, Gabe Almanzor with 6. Timber Burnham with 1. Zach Jacobson with 10. Drew Marker with a team-high 16. Zach Vickers with 7. Morgan House with 13, Charlie Blanc with 7, and Brian Castle with 5.
Well, rebounding, 38 rebounds for the Haines Glacier Bears, 31 for the Craig Panthers. Leading rebounder was Marker with that one. He had 9 rebounds in that one for the Haines Glacier Bears. Swinton finished with 12 boards in there. Shooting percentage-wise, Glacier Bears 21 for 43 at 48% for the ball game. And the Craig Panthers put up 60 shots, got 21 of those to go for 35%. I want to remind folks that there is another game there. There's a game going on in Craig right now. That girls game is going on there. But we're going to be back on the air again at 7 o'clock tomorrow. So you want to definitely tune in for that one. So we'll be back to the Carl Ward Gymnasium for the second game of this two-game series between the Craig Panthers and the Haines Glacier Bears. We'll see you tomorrow night.